and should also bear sons. Would you wait? Imagine maybe they are in their 30s, or maybe 35, and say, even if you are to wait, I conceive today for a son. By the time that son is going to grow to be 30, you'll be 60, 70. So there is nothing that you can look at. Just go back. Would you wait for them as they did? Would you restrain yourselves from having husbands? No, my daughters, I'm feeling for you, for it is grieving me very much for your sake that the hand of the Lord has gone against me. When bad things happen, most people think God is fighting me. God has stayed against me. But that is the interpretation of man. God can never do bad things to us. The enemy, the devil, does that. Now here, verse 14. They lifted up their voices and wept again. And Orpah kissed her mother-in-law. But Ruth cried to Naomi. Orpah says, enough is enough. I am going back. I pray this afternoon, may you not be the Orpah of this generation. Never give up. Ruth says, I am not giving up. I was moved when the sister was telling that story. The whole country, the whole everything, the whole of your environment, the whole of the things you know is gone. What do? You sit down and start crying? You say, this is the end of me. No way. We must put ourselves together, shake the dust off, and say, I'm going to march on and trust God. Amen. So Orpah went back. Now the two friends has remained by the name of Ruth to Naomi, her mother in verse 15, and said, look, your sister, this is Naomi telling the truth. Look, your sister in law has gone back to her people and to her gods. Return also, look at your friend and go. This is what I want to end with today, verse 16 of Ruth chapter 9.